Hi guys, welcome to javainterviewquestions.com. Today we'll see one important SAJP question on for loop and for each loop. I repeat once again, we'll see one important SAJP question on for loop and for each loop. So this tutorial will help you in learning the for loop and for each loop, and when will we go you need to use the iterator and for loop. Yeah, and here is the example. First I will go through the question, then I will explain you the answers, then I will give you the explanation. First, public class bar static void foo int x. So int colon colon x is nothing but varargs, that means variable number of arguments. X can accept multiple arguments. So at line number 12 we need to insert code from the options given below. We have 4 options ABCD, we need to insert these 4 options in the line 12. So what was the question? Which two code fragments inserted independently at line 12 will allow the class to compile? So from the 4 options, 2 options will allow the code to compile. We need to find out which two will allow the code to compile, why are they allowing to compile, and which two are not allowing to compile, and what were the reasons. So first one, will come to the first option, for each loop system.out.println z. So for each loop system.out.println z. So this option is not correct, this is invalid. So the explanation for this is, here the argument name is x. Okay, what we are trying to do, since it accepts variable number of arguments, we can iterate through this x. That means x will act like an integer array. So for each of x system.out.println z, here we don't have anywhere the variable z, okay, but we are trying to print system.out.println z. So what happens, we will get a compilation error. Next, for int z colon x system.out.println z. So coming to this option, for int z colon x system.out.println z, okay, this option is a valid option. Why? Because since x is an array or it holds a multiple objects, so what we can do, we can use for each loop in Java. So what it will do, it will iterate through each value in the array and we are printing. So that we are doing here. First, what we are doing, for int z colon x, so we are taking x. X means what? It accepts multiple values, and in that what we are doing, we are naming the each value as z. And what we are doing, we are printing system.out.println z. So this option is correct. So first option is what? B. So B is correct. And next, coming to the C, while has x.hasNext system.out.println x.next. so the third option is, while x.hasNext system.out.println x.next. so why this option is not a valid option, this is not the correct answer. Why? Because x dot has next, x is what? It's a variable, just simply a variable. But what we are trying to do, we are calling has next method. Okay, we don't have has next method in that x. Okay, we have has next method in iterator. So if we have iterator on x object, we can call like this. But here we don't have an iterator, we just only have variable. So x dot has next means we'll get a compilation error like, we don't have has next method. So the C option is wrong. And coming to the D option, D option is correct option. For int I equals to 0, I less than x dot length, I plus plus system dot out dot println x of I. So this option is not a valid option, it's a wrong option. This is a valid option. Why? Because we are trying to what? We are trying to iterate each element in the array. For int I equals to 0, I less than x dot length, so how many number of values you are passing, that value will be there here. Assume that if you have 3 values, I will be less than 3, I plus plus system.out.println x of I. So for the first value it will be x of 1, second value it will be x of 2, and third value it will be x of 3. So D and B are the correct options, A and C are the wrong options. Hope you guys understood the video. Thanks for watching this video. If you like my video, subscribe to my videos.